With war, it's easy to speak of tragedy. But I think what's important is the strength to overcome the pain and establish peace. Welcome back, my loyal subjects, to more Trails in the Sky. Pharaoh Fiasco still here, and last episode, we did the second to last request, and then we started Orvid's request to actually find... Oh, crap. We started Orvid's request to actually track down whatever the heck he was after, but I couldn't actually find it, and I was going crazy. I had the most whack job theories about what exactly I needed to do to actually get this particular thing to show up. So I ended up saying screw it. It was length long. So I'm assuming that there's something else that has to happen in between now and when I can actually do the request. You'll actually see it came up briefly when during the battle. Joshua's got 110 EP now. Off screen, I killed a bunch of those. I actually don't know what they're called. But I killed a bunch of the plant monsters and they actually gave out some water sepeth crap, which is exactly what we were after. And I set up Joshua with a evade wind quartz, because it would increase his agility. And you know what? I'm gonna get like one experience from this thing, but I'm gonna take like 200 damage from it. So that's just not a good trade. Okay, so we're gonna go, crap! It's specifically set up. Oh man, having four characters in the party is gonna be a nightmare until I actually get around to remapping this so I can walk instead of running all over the place. But we are, no! God dang it. These things, and everybody gets to take their turn first. Okay. So as long as Estelle doesn't get too jacked up. Okay, so we can run. Thankfully, there doesn't seem to be any percentage chance about whether or not we'll actually escape. If we try it, we're gonna succeed. Which is also kind of bad, because more than once I've accidentally run away from a fight that I wasn't trying to run away from. Okay, can't change that at all. We're back in the Malga Mine. Let me actually review what we're even doing here. The mine chief should be somewhere in the mine. Okay. Everyone's a little stronger. I think we're up one level, and we're about to hit our next one. So as long as there are new monsters we haven't actually encountered here, though... Oh, it's one of those mazes. So what I'm expecting, though, because I initially came here straight from the last story mission, so it's probably still balanced around me being that level. Do I have to... Can I move this now? Check it out! It's a minecart! Do you think it's powered by Orbments too? Looks that way to me. How about we get in and see where it takes us? That seems like a really dangerous idea, so I'm surprised Joshua is the one who had it. Oh, we switched the lever so it took us here instead of wherever that other place is. Hold on, let's ride back again, and then we're gonna hit the lever, because we should go that way once it comes back. And that'll probably take us to a dead end. But it also probably has a treasure chest here. Yup, knew it. Oh, some guy. Great Adios! What are you kids doing down here? Are you friends with someone who works here in the mine? Not exactly. We've come to see the mine chief at the request of the mayor. Oh, so you're here about the crystal, are you? Well, if you're looking for the boss, he should be in the tunnels below. If you use the elevator at the end of the tracks on the opposite side of the mine, you can get down there. The end of the tracks on the opposite side of the mine? When you are riding in the minecart, you notice the place along the way where the track diverges, right? If you follow that other line, you'll reach the elevator. In order to get there, you'll have to go back to where you came from and flip the lever to activate the track switch. Okay, so the one thing in the game that I figure out on my own, and that guy pretty much tells us exactly what I felt like a genius over. So that was entirely pointless, but oh well. Alright, so let's do what we were initially gonna do. There was no treasure at the end of the road. Just a minecart. This is the elevator we're supposed to use to reach the lower tunnels, right? Oh! I'm guessing Estelle wouldn't have known what to do if we hadn't talked to him? Why doesn't it work? Let me have a look. Okay. There's orbital energy running through it, but it appears to be mechanically locked. Maybe we should go back and ask that miner about it. Oh, so we have to... Wow. That's a lot of times you have to ride this minecart back and forth. I guess they're really trying to drill down into us this whole, the mechanic of the mine. So now that we had to do it 6 times in a row, we're not going to forget that this is exactly what we should expect from the rest of the dungeon. What's that you say? The elevator wouldn't work. Ah, I see what the problem is. You need the key to activate it. But since you don't have one of your own, I'll help you out by lending you mine. He is extremely trusting of 2 teenagers who randomly appeared in the mine. Being a bracer must be big stuff. Borrowed elevator key. Much appreciated. Once our business here is finished, we'll make sure to return it. I wonder if it'll force me to return it, or if that's something I can do for extra BP. And since I didn't get any extra BP on those last 2 requests I turned in, I'm on the lookout for anything that'll give me more. So I'll see. That sounds right. Being considerate of other people, making sure we uphold the Bracer Guild values and stuff. Estelle, try using that key we borrowed. We should be able to get the elevator working this time. Estelle used the elevator key. It looks like we can use the elevator now. How about we head down into the lower tunnels? Use elevator. Okay. Okay. Nothing too major so far. Okay, there's nothing in that minecart. There's another one. But there should... We could go this way also. No monsters so far. That's surprising. Ah! You scared me there for a second. So you're looking for the mine chief, are you? I'm sure he's somewhere across the bridge. Okay, so we have to ride the bridge across now. I wonder what the... We probably need to go back and consult him? Oh. Ooh. Rest. Oh, okay. I didn't even realize it was at half health. But if they put this here, there's probably a fight waiting for us. So let's save. And then we're gonna delve in. 2 miners. The reason why we've been able to work like we have is due to the grace of the goddess herself. We'd best remember to give thanks. You do that. I say adios a lot, but I don't actually believe in her. You said you're looking for the mine chief? He was here a moment ago. Okay, Heinrich. This must be him. Heaven and earth. What are 2 kids like you doing down here in the mine? You're the mine chief, right? Boy, am I glad to see you. We've been searching all over this dank place for you. We're with the Bracer Guild, and we've come today on behalf of Mayor Klaus. Handed over the mayor's referral. I see. So you kids are bracers, are you? That's quite a feat for being so young. It's not that big of a deal. By the way, you're supposed to have some sort of crystal for us, right? Oh right, give me a second. This little baby is something you don't see every day. Which is why I've been keeping it as close to myself as possible. Mary Curie did that, dude, and that didn't turn out so well for her. The mine chief pulls a large grain crystal from his breast pocket. That must be Winsepith. Wow. I've never seen a crystal this big before!
That is impressive. There seems to be a light swirling around inside too.
It's one of several types of septium. Specifically, it's an Ismelis crystal, which is endowed with the power of wind. So there must be other ones which are endowed with the power of the other elements too.
For a gem of this size, you're looking at a hefty price tag. I'm talking about a small fortune here.
Make absolutely sure that this gets to the mayor.
Roger that.
Received septium crystal.
It's so beautiful. It feels like I'm carrying a little fairy in my hand.
This is super fun. Check this out, Joshua.
That's nice and all, but how about you stop horsing around? If you drop it, we could be in some real trouble.
Fine, you big killjoy.
Estelle put the crystal away in her pocket.
Well, I guess that's that. We'll get out of your hair now, Mr. Gatton, but don't worry, we'll make sure this gets to the mayor.
I'm counting on you kids. Huh?
What's the matter?
That's odd. The airflow down here suddenly shifted. Are the higher elements at work?
Hold on. The airflow?
This scent. It's a monster.
Whoa!
Ah!
Joshua seems like he'd have the ability to detect the higher elements.
Is it over? What was that earthquake just now?
No, it seems there's been a cave-in somewhere in the mine. I wonder if one of the miners hit a patch of loose ground. I'd better check on the extent of the damage. Look out, Estelle.
Huh?
This thing. Okay, but we're in tip-top fighting shape. We have to protect the mining chief? Okay, I'm not too worried. Let's start off with a, okay, killer crab. Okay, I can actually attack with Joshua, and then we can immediately get his, S-craft. There we go. See, guys? I'm learning. Slowly but surely. Alright. There we go. Oh! I didn't expect to do that much damage. 69? Okay, these are probably more balanced around if I hadn't done all that other stuff. So Estelle is going to airstrike to start her turn off. A 60. Not worried about that at all. He doesn't move very far. A strength up on the airstrike. Not too much. 141. Let's see. And Joshua's also got a strength up.
Miss! I gave him the evade plus one specifically so that wouldn't happen.
Aw, crap. We can firebolt this one.
Why is he moving closer? That's probably gonna get really horrible in the coming things.
Okay, Estelle is now going to finish this thing off. And then we're gonna have Joshua dual strike for the other kill. And that should be game. Craft, dual strike. One, two, okay. So now Joshua's gotta survive a hit from this thing. Nope. Guess who gets my one and only reviving balm? We should get way more money from after this thing, though, so. Okay. Joshua's back up, and if I played better, that wouldn't have happened. Okay, Estelle took that hit. Okay, so now Joshua can attack for game. There we go. Okay, 622. Monster carapace times two.
What? Why are there? Do you usually have problems with monsters like this?
No, this is the first time we've ever had anything like this happen down here. Monsters have a predisposition which attracts them to the glow of Septium, so we've had a lot of them wander into the mine in the past, but judging from the situation, it may be that the recent cave-in opened up a hole connected to a den of monsters. Did you say a den of monsters? It's not inconceivable. But this is no time to be standing around thinking about it. I've got to get the other workers out of here.
If that's the case, then how about letting us help you out?
You're kidding, right?
Monster extermination is right up our alley, and besides, every minute counts.
You're right. Some extra help would be much appreciated. So how many miners are we looking at in all? There should only be 4 others working here in the lower tunnels.
Got it. Now let's go find them.
Sorry about all this. Oh right, take these and use them if you need to. Receive tear bomb times 2. Aw, crap.
And the miners in our party?
Dang. Okay, hold on. First, hold on, what can we use? Okay, tier. We'll have Joshua cast tier twice. And then, how much? Obviously, I think they only gave us like 11, but I can't remember for the life of me, so now I have to kill a couple of them to see. I just want to see how much they give us as far as experience goes, because Estelle is only 18 away from her next level. A firebolt. An airstrike. You're dead. And a firebolt for the kill. Miss! Excellent! And hopefully Estelle can level up from this, if I could be so lucky.
We're good to go!
8. Dang, I need to kill 2 more. And where's that Orbink charging station?
Wait, was I always not able to bring up the map down here?
Probably. Okay, we have... Don't come any closer! I'm not trying to brag, but I'm all muscle, so it wouldn't make a tasty meal.
Me too! I'm not delicious either! All this flab would be terrible for a monster's health!
Oh, we have to save them. Okay, cool. We don't have 4 people to protect, thankfully. Let's start with an airstrike. 75. 48, and that one can't get us just yet. So you, oh man, I probably shouldn't have fought that one thing. At least Joshua's gonna critical, so maybe if we get lucky, a kill? No, crap. But it should go down to 1 dual strike, so I'm not too worried. Let's see, okay, a craft from here, dual strike, 40. Yeah, just to be on the safe side.
Unless both of them miss, what is this, I ask you?
And double EP heals, or HP heals. Okay, so Estelle is gonna try to bring this back with a firebolt on this one. So that'll get one of them off the board. Okay, so we even this up officially. Now let's have Joshua try this again with less failure this time. God dang it. Okay.
Is there a way for me to heal him? Because I hope there's a way for me to freaking heal that guy.
Okay, so Estelle. Ooh. If we can't heal him, this might be a retry. Attack. Joshua can get the kill on him. The miner is gonna take 1 more hit. Oh no, cool. It didn't go after the miner. Okay, so Estella's gonna use her last firebolt. I'm so glad there's an Orbment recharging station because we did not have enough to carry us through this.
Piece of cake.
And 12. Excellent! Estelle learned Hurricane! Thank you, her first offensive craft. You're safe now, guys. Thank you for coming when you did. Oh man, for a minute there, I thought I'd never be able to sit down for another meal again.
This is no time to feel relieved. We need to evacuate this place. Any more lollygagging, you're going to be sitting in the belly of one of these monsters. Yes, boss.
Wait for me! Man, living in Zemuria is really freaking dangerous, dude. Wait, if they have monster problems, but there are no bracers? How do they deal with all the monsters? Because class 7 can't be everywhere. Okay, that's not a question for Trails in the Sky. Let me worry about Trails in the Sky stuff. How close is Joshua to leveling up, actually? 590, 640? Yeah. We're gonna keep going, but we're gonna go ahead and let the chips fall where they may, as far as Joshua goes.
Estelle's offensive- Ah! Things weren't supposed to go like this! I don't wanna die, I haven't even had a girlfriend yet! Help!
Okay, so... He's either asking, whoa, he either wants us or the elite beat agents.
Hey, where are you going? That way leads to the monster den. The bedrock is also still unstable, so how about we do ourselves a favor and keep away from there?
It certainly doesn't look that safe either.
Alright, let's turn back.
Okay, let's kill these things. Three of them, and we just got healed up. Not worried at all. And Joshua should hit 600 from this. Okay, let's actually go ahead. We're gonna start Joshua off with an airstrike. And then we're gonna see what Estelle's hurricane art is all about. It might be like Laura's brilliant spin, actually. No, it pushes them away, and it deals no damage. We're probably not gonna be using that a whole lot. Okay, the game is probably trying to tell me something, but I'm sure I can fix Estelle's strength issues with enough quartz and stuff. And also always upgrading her first. I'm gonna make Estelle into a physical attacker because that's what I want her to be. God dang it. Okay. Okay, an airstrike. Murders that thing. And then Estelle should get another kill from her firebolt. Or maybe I should have been paying attention. Okay, so Joshua, if we dual strike, we can kill this thing, and then I want Estelle to try finishing this thing off? Okay, maybe I spread this out pretty badly. Yeah, we got close to killing both of them, but... Okay, cool, because I think I might need to heal the miner. Unless Estelle's about to die. No. Okay, cool. Let me check tier. Okay, the miner heals every fight, so we're good there. I'm gonna have Joshua heal Estelle. And he got an HP heal himself, so that's good. Estelle? We're not healing back to full from tier anymore. So we're changing... So we're not super scrubs anymore. That thing's dead, but that thing's got a strength up. That's a critical wasted on the boss, but we should be getting the last laugh with Joshua. Yep, easy.
Alright, we're good to go.
Okay, so Estelle only got 6 from that, actually. And Joshua got 2, so 640, one monster carapace.
Oh man, you kids saved my skin! Don't worry, you're safe now. A handful of monsters are no match for the likes of a bracer.
Did you say bracers? What are you doing in a place like this?
By the suit on my boots, you're the new recruit from yesterday. Why on earth are you digging down here in the lower tunnels?
I was hoping to get a glimpse of how all you veteran miners work down here. Yeah, that's it. when suddenly the wall collapsed and a flood of monsters came in from the other side.
So we've got ourselves a veritable nest of monsters now, huh? It looks like you guessed right, kid.
So it seems. The area up ahead is dangerous. It's swarming with monsters. Anyway, I'm out of here. Would you look at him run? He must have been really scared.
I bet. And I can't go any further. Okay. So first things first. Where's that at? Heals. I need the heals. Nope. I need the real heals first.
No! God dang it.
And they surprise attacked us. Okay, we may need to run from this one. Yep, the music changed, and that's our cue. Get the heck out of there. Rest up. Okay. Save. Estella's only level 8. Not even double digits yet. Okay. Wait, he said there were 4 down here, right?
I'm sorry, but there are still others who need rescuing. Can I get you to lend me a hand for a bit longer?
Wait, so... Okay, so I must... Where could this other person even be? He's not over here. He's not over here. Is he back here somewhere?
God dang it!
Call for backup. Yeah, let's not even bother, because we have more story bosses to fight. There it is.
Oh, Adios, who art in heaven, extend to us thy saving hand.
Hey, idiot! If you've got time to pray to the goddess, then how about helping me take care of these creatures?
These guys were down here? Huh. I guess I did talk to them.
How could I forget about good old Pierre and Heinrich?
Okay, airstrike to start. Okay. Okay, and now Joshua can cast his S-craft. But Estelle is gonna firebolt this same one, just to make sure we've got it all dead. Airstrike. Then a firebolt. Okay, so that takes Joshua's next closest turn off and moves it up. Okay, so I know now. 2 and 3 for 171. If Joshua, okay, because if Joshua got double targeted again, that would have been bad. Because we do not have any items to heal him up, that is for sure. Let's Aqua Bleed for the kill. Estelle's Firebolt is going to half health it. That thing is going to get a strength up when it goes next. Estelle got 72'd. And he wasted our Sepith up. Let's go ahead and just basic attack the rest of this guy. Ooh, no, no, no. Okay, not move. There we go. He'll get one more attack off, but this is fine. Joshua will kill him next turn. And even if Joshua misses, Estelle will get it. Okay, cool.
Alright, we're good to go.
12. Monster Carapace. Joshua's a couple fights away.
Is everyone alright?
We are now, thanks to you kids. This must also be the divine work of Adios.
What a religious nut.
If this was really the work of the goddess, then she wouldn't have allowed us to get into this mess in the first place.
It's because of unbelievers like you that unfortunate accidents like this happen.
How about you try and say that again, buddy?
This is really the time or place for that kind of nonsense. Now get out of here!
Right away, boss.
You be careful too, boss.
So it looks like
I think Heinrich is the first person I've seen who actively didn't believe in Adios, or who openly didn't completely adhere to her teachings. He never said he didn't believe in her. But I think that's the first bit of the— oh my god! Other than the oh my god I just said, it seems to be the first bit of theological dissent. You know what? I'm not even gonna go back to heal. We're fine with this. We're fine with a little bit of damage on us. Cause now we should be able to leave. Did we find everybody? Yes, that should be everyone. All right then, let's get out of here ourselves. Okay, and now do we have to do the same thing up here though? Are you all right, boss? I'm sure glad you're safe. You can thank these kids for that. By the way, is everyone accounted for? Yep, everyone's here. Well, except for the new guy who took off like a bat out of hell. The poor guy must have wet himself scared. I see. Well, I hope he doesn't give up on being a miner after this. Anyway, there's a high possibility that there are monsters still in the lower tunnels. Until we can confirm that it's safe, I don't want anyone using the elevator, you hear me? So, am I able to go down, go back into the monster den, and exterminate them that way? That was a huge miscalculation on my part. Did this freaking guy do that on purpose? I never expected monsters to surface or bracers to show up. I guess I just have to report the truth about everything that happened. That freaking traitor! I don't know who the heck he is, but I hate him already. I apologize for getting you involved in more than your fair share of work today. I'll get in touch with the guild a little later on and make sure you two are compensated fairly. Don't sweat it. We just did what anyone would have done in our position. And besides, it's all part of our training to become full-fledged bracers. By the way, what do you intend to do about the lower tunnels? I don't know, but we'll figure out some way to deal with it. There's always the option of sealing off the monster den with some explosives. As a heads up, I may ask the guild for help if we run into any other serious trouble. Sure, you can count on us. And we'll make sure this crystal gets to the mayor as intended. You did make sure that you didn't drop it, right, Right, Estelle? How rude. I'm not that careless. Look, it's right. Oh, come on. You didn't. You lost it? Oh, the fake out. Psych, I've got it right here. Let's go make that delivery, shall we? You are unbelievable. Young lady, those are the kind of words that'll give an old man like me a heart attack. Dude, for a split second, I was so scared that we'd have to go back into the lower tunnels and search for it. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead, turn in this request, make sure we don't run into any monsters. Whoa! These freaking things! They have the biggest hate on for us! I know it's because we're running through the thing, but still! Jeez! Okay, party fled. So we are out. Nope. Okay, no! Come on, Joshua! Pick up the pace, dude! You gotta figure something out, Joshua, because now you're dead. And I bet we still get into fights if they touch Joshua. It's just those stupid— oh my, Adios, dude. This thing has a death wish. Okay, hold on. Let me be so kind as to grant it really quickly. Let him have it, Estelle. Freaking die. And Joshua falls behind even further. Takes the way out. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna skip right to when we get back into town from here, actually. Okay, we're back in town. First, we're actually going to talk to the mayor just to let him know or give him the item itself. All right. Where the heck is he?
We were in his study, right? Okay, that's some chick. Not the mayor's room. Not the mayor's room. Heck is he? There we go. Girl in uniform. I see. I would never have imagined that the clock tower had such an anecdote to go with it. I'm totally blown away after hearing that.
With war, it's easy to speak of tragedy. But I think what's important is the strength to overcome the pain and establish peace. Well, who do we have here?
We've come to deliver the object you requested. Did we catch you in the middle of something?
Oh, Estelle and Joshua, you are no trouble at all. Whoever that blue-haired chick is, I really hope she joins our party.
In fact, you've come at a good time. Let me introduce you to my guest. This is Josette. She's a student at the Genus Royal Academy.
Sounds like they might rival Thor's!
The Genus Royal Academy?
I've heard of it before. It's a boarding school for higher education in the Ruan region, right?
Yes, that's right. It's a pleasure to meet you. My name is Josette Har. I'm Estelle. It's nice to meet you, Josette.
You can call me Joshua.
The two of them are actually bracers. I had asked them to do a personal job for me. Oh, she was talking to, she was the girl who was talking to Father Divine.
Bracers? You mean the proud knights of freedom who love peace above all else and do not to succumb to any power? This is such an inspiring moment. I never thought I'd run into any real bracers. The inspiring part sounds a little much. By the way, is it all right if I just call you Josette?
Yes, please do.
So, why did you come to Rolent? Are you a friend of the mayor's?
No, today is actually the first time we've ever met. I'm researching the important cultural assets of each region as a part of my independent studies. And although I thought he might be busy, I've been lucky enough to get an audience with the mayor.
You're really serious about your studies, aren't you?
Maybe we're intruding a bit, huh?
No, I've already asked the mayor enough questions. Instead, maybe it is I who am in the way.
Don't be silly, it's not like that at all. Estelle, this is a great opportunity, so how about showing her what you've brought with you?
Sure, hold on a second. Oh my word, that's septium, right? What a wonderful glow it gives off.
Yes, and its size is impressive too. That is, indeed, a gift worthy of expressing the appreciation of all Rolent's citizens.
A gift?
Worthy of expressing our appreciation.
I see. So this is a gift for the Queen's anniversary.
You're sharp, Joshua. So this is a present for Alfin and Cedric's mom.
I intend to send an engraved ornament using this to the Queen. As a token of Rolent's citizens' appreciation to Her Majesty, who will be turning 60 years old.
So it's a present for the Queen! How delightful!
We, as citizens of Laboral, owe Her Majesty a great debt for all she has done for us. In fact, the reason why we can use an airliner with such ease is because of the support of the royal family. I've even heard that the Bracer Guild in Laboral has received support from the royal family. We do owe her a great debt of gratitude.
Wow, that's pretty amazing! And can you believe it, Joshua? We carried a present for the Queen with these very hands!
And what's more, you ran around with it in those hands like a wild maniac.
You weren't supposed to tell anyone!
I wouldn't have imagined anything less from you, Estelle.
You guys... Here you go, Mayor Klaus. It has been faithfully delivered.
Gave Septium Crystal to the mayor.
Thank you very much.
And as a matter of precaution...
He's putting it in his safe. So either Josette is going to turn out to be cool and join our party, or she's going to turn out to be a total traitor and she's going to steal it or something.
Okay, it'll be safe in there.
Now that now all that's left is to have Melder's Orbital Factory finish up the engraving on its ornament.
I can't wait to see what it'll look like when it's done.
Don't hog it all to yourself when you do. Let me see it too when it's finished, okay? It's too bad I won't be here to see it for myself. But today I was lucky enough to speak with the mayor and see something as beautiful as that. How shall I ever thank you?
Don't mention it. This is all part of my job as a mayor.
Thank you for everything. But I think it's time for me to say goodbye. I think we should be going ourselves.
Agreed. Have a nice day, Mayor Klaus. Yourselves as well.
So you're heading home tomorrow on the airliner, are you?
Yes, that's right. School's about to begin.
I see. So you use your school vacation time to come here.
That's too bad. We could have made great friends. I hope we can meet again sometime.
There's nothing I would like more.
Please have a wonderful day, Estelle, Joshua.
Yeah, I feel like she's going to join.
What a nice girl. For looking like someone from a rich family, she wasn't snooty at all.
Yeah.
Joshua? Oh, could I be correct in assuming that she's your type?
What? What are you talking about?
You're blushing! I'm really surprised! I had no idea that you were into the rich girl type. We'll have to get some pickup lines ready for the next time you meet.
Quit getting all excited about nothing.
Especially when you have no idea what others are thinking.
Huh?
Just never mind. Anyway, let's report to the guild. The next job we're doing for Dad will be the last one.
Oh, right! Alright, let's get pumped and knock this last one out!
Okay, so we finally managed that, got all the Malga stuff done. So now, next episode, we're gonna turn these requests in and get started on the final one. Join me then for more Trails in the Sky. Bye for now, guys.
Also, we're gonna heal up Joshua. Always life a dream.